It's been 1 year to the day since marijuana became legal in Canada. There's been plenty of highs as well as lows. We're inside Tokyo's Smoke on Yonge Street, where cannabis connoisseurs, even first-timers, can get a curated experience. Though the illegal market in the last 12 months, it hasn't gone anywhere. It is still a budding business, and they're taking a big bite of the pot pie.
I would love for us to have snapped our fingers and everyone moved to the legal market. We know that's not the case.
Stats Canada's quarterly report found that more than 40% of cannabis users purchased their weed illegally. One black market dealer we spoke with recently told us his roster of clients has exploded to the point where he's struggling to keep up with demand.
There's more clients than product right now. You know, so just getting your hands on it is the task. You gotta look everywhere.
You're looking for growers across the country to meet the demand of your clients.
Yeah, I have to.
So you have pre-rolls, you have your dried flowers, you have your oils.
Today inside a bustling Tokyo Smoke, staff greet you with an iPod in hand and a wealth of knowledge. Though Josh Lyon with Canopy Growth notes that the slow rollout of the provincially approved stores in Ontario has been one of the big challenges.
A province like Ontario, we have 24 stores right now for a population of, it's called 11 million. Alberta has just under 300 stores for a population much smaller. So it's about access to product. People want easy. People want convenient. And as an industry, we have to be able to give that to them.
There's no doubt that the legit, legal marijuana industry is big business. Tokyo Smoke, which was started in Toronto, was purchased by Canopy Growth for more than $200 million. Though multiple consumers we've spoken to this year say the price for legal weed is too much to stomach.
They know how much they should be paying for it, as opposed to going to the government-regulated shops and seeing, like, oh, like, why am I spending $70 when I can get the same amount and spend less than $40?
You have to have all parts of the marketing mix working in sync in order to be successful. So, yes, distribution is what we're talking about, but pricing as well. If you don't have both of these things in sync, you're going to find that people will do something else, which in this case is the black market.
The average price of an illegal gram of weed is still about $4 cheaper across the country. Marketing professor David Silberman believes it's not enough for government-sanctioned weed shops to simply find a way to meet the prices of the black market. They have to beat them if they want to break consumer habits.
People develop habits, and when those habits become ingrained, it's very difficult to get people to change.
It might be the cannaversary, though, as you just heard. There's still only 24 legal government-sanctioned dispensaries in the province of Ontario. Compare that with more than 600 LCBOs, though Josh Lyon with Canopy Growth says this is just year one. We're only 12 months in. He's confident the business model in Ontario is set to thrive, especially once more stores are able to open.